Friends, welcome back to my channel. I have this Beko washing machine circuit board. It is using Z0103M TRIAC. How we can test within circuit safely? Basically, it is a comment from my viewer. My viewer is saying, sir, I saw a video of a person testing TRIAC on washing machine motherboard. He don't desolder TRIAC. He use series lamp and multimeter on milliampere mode. And I don't understand very well. Can you please explain these method? Thank you. Let's see. In this board, it is using Z0103M TRIAC. Before performing the test, let's see this datasheet for that one. It is SOT223 package. Pin 1, that is terminal 1, pin 2 is terminal 2, pin 3 is gate, pin 4 is terminal 2. So terminal 2 center pin and the tab, that is terminal 2. Here is the symbol. It is 1 ampere 600 volts TRIAC. TRIAC is used to switch AC voltage, line voltage. If we are using 110 volt or 220 volt, so it will use. Terminal 1 is connected to common, neutral, and we connect any load. Between line and neutral, TRIAC is a gate triggered component. It works like a relay. We apply trigger current at gate. This Z0103, its latching current for the gate trigger current, that is 3 milliampere. So we need maximum 3 milliampere current to trigger the gate. That is maximum. This point must be considered, that this is maximum limit. And here if we see VGT, gate trigger voltage, that is 1.3 volt. It is also maximum limit. Gate trigger voltage will be considered between these two points. As my viewer says that he is using in milliampere mod or ampere mod, milliampere mod. In the milliampere mod, we use multimeter as a shunt resistance. So when we will make jumper between these two points, we will switch these voltage directly to the gate. It is not 100% chances to damage this track. We can say 99.9% chances are to damage this gate, because we are exceeding from its maximum voltage limit. If you connect here, it will not turn on. If you will make jumper between terminal 1 and gate, it will not trigger. It need that trigger current and that trigger voltage between these two terminals. We have 220 volts. First, we will calculate DC voltage, 311 volts. 311 minus 1.3 volts, 309, and the maximum current, that is 0.003. So we need 103 kilo ohm resistance. So we can use 100 kilo ohm resistance. 110 kilo ohm resistance, that is sufficient. But we will not use multimeter in ampere or milliampere mode. Yeah, it is 100 kilo ohm resistance. If you don't have good practical experience in power electronics, never do this experiment, because it have live voltage. If you see this board, here is line and neutral. The line voltage or neutral voltage, one line is connected directly at this point. and it is distributed to terminal 1 of every TRIAC, that is leftmost pin. So each pin, each TRIAC is receiving voltage. In this board, the one TRIAC that is damaged, and terminal 4 or terminal 2, the center tape, it is connected to output points. So we can say when it will turn on, it will receive trigger voltage at trigger, the pin number 3, right side pin. It will switch voltage from this point to the output point and we will drive any load. So these are output points. I will use series lamp. Always take care for the safety. Now I will connect one lead to this common point, that is here. This point, it is common point reaching to the TRIAC's terminal 1. And this end, we will take a pair of test probes and we will take 100 kilo ohm resistance here. We will connect the wire that is coming from series lamp, and we will connect this common probe here. One lead we will consider as a test probe. This end of the test probe we will connect here. Now our circuit is in this shape. One line of this test lamp or series lamp is going to the AC input terminal that is connected to common points of these TRIACs. The second wire, the line wire that is coming here directly, and this wire, it is connected to 100 kilo ohm resistance here. Now how we will test? Keep it in some isolated place. Now I will power on, and these are test probes. Now how we will test? This is our now test probe and this is signal. If we will connect to the line terminal that is connected here, this is connected to terminal 1, that is left side pin of each TRIAC. The lamp is glowing. But if we will connect to terminal 2, that is here, the lamp is off. Now what we need a trigger signal. We are connecting here 100 kilo ohm resistance. Now we will touch this signal to the gate. The lamp is turned on. That means this TRIAC is good. This TRIAC is bad. If you will touch here, it will not turn on. If we touch to pin number 1, the lamp is on. That means the line voltage are reaching at this point, but it is not providing output. When we will touch the signal to the gate, it is not turning on. The next TRIAC, it is turning on. We will touch this signal probe to the gate pin. And if we will touch to the pin number 1, no problem. Pin number 2, no problem. Pin number 3, that is right side pin, that time that TRIAC will turn on. So this is the safe method for testing TRIAC within circuit. Now let's see if we will connect multimeter in milliampere mode, at that time we will bring this voltage to gate. It can damage the other circuit as well, because in multimeter in milliampere mode there is just only one short link, that is shunt resistance. So there is no load, there is no resistance, so we will never use multimeter in milliampere mode. If the TRIAC is short circuit internally, it will damage the multimeter or it will damage the circuit. Okay, let me connect this resistance to terminal 1. The common point . If you connect this resistance at terminal 1 and gate, it is not turning on, because the TRIAC needs voltage between terminal 2 and gate. Finally, we can say it is the simplest most method to test TRIAC within circuit. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.